So far, how many, I mean, single album did you release?
I released a Christmas album. Mm-hmm. We tried to release it fast, so that was the first one in December of last year. And then I released my own little mini album called Shane's World, which was released around end of March. Mm-hmm. And then I just released a duet album with Kimbo Young, who's also part of our company. Yeah,
that's the recent one, right? Mm-hmm. So which one is your favorite, actually?
It's hard.
You can't talk about it.
Well, like, I can. I like a lot of them, but, like, mm-hmm. I want to say I'm proud of my own albums, because mm-hmm. I really like the song Iyagi that I was able to write the melody for.
Yes.
I was able to write that, so I'm pretty proud of that, and, mm-hmm. But I'm even more proud of Summer Love, which is on...
Oh, I like this song.
I want to be known as, like, kind of, what's it called? Singer-songwriter. I want to go for that kind of image. That's why I feel so proud to have written a song in Korean. That's, like, my first song that I ever wrote in Korean, like, melody... And lyrics, and just
so
some of those
have like
two versions.
Right?
There's three versions. Then there's one duet version. Uh-huh. There's a Korean version and an English.
Oh yes, Korean version.
So that was
duet means like which means like
with Kim Bo Kyung.
Yes.
So yeah, it has three versions now, and I feel so happy to have released that because I made that so long ago, and I want to be known as a singer songwriter.
Anyways, I have like bunch of questions right now, so of course I have to ask you.
Of course.
So from Twitter's Piano Girls said, I'll ask you, did you compose or write any song after Iyagi? You know,
I did, but it's hard because honestly, the melody can come a lot easier to me than lyrics, especially not knowing how to. Fluently, you know, like really comfortably speak Korean. Its lyrics are still really, really hard for me.
Yes, of course.
And but the melody obviously is there. I have a lot of melodies that I need to add lyrics to. So I guess that's my answer for that.
Okay.
I have
someone like translate for you, or if you you're trying to create something like lyrics and write things. Mm-hmm.
Whenever I get the chance, I try and write something. And sometimes, like, I always have my phone with me with a recording app. So, like, in case a melody comes into my head, it's like,
okay,
better record that and then save it for later and make a song out of it. Mm-hmm. So,
And then Wandu Eungyeong asked you, do you feel like any pressures or stress because you're our singer, right?
Yeah.
You're a singer-songwriter, so you have to create something all the time, right?
All the time, yeah.
Do you have any a solution for that or any stress pressures?
Yeah, I get pressured, especially when my company is sometimes our company is like, Shane, you better write a song, seriously. You got to write one really fast. And I hate being pressured to get something out because I don't want to rush things. I want to take my time on them and make them good and be proud with them. So there's always that pressure of having to create something new, and sometimes I might not have the idea, but there's always that pressure, but I try my best, and I definitely really want to become a good singer-songwriter, so I'm doing my best.
That's good for you, man. And also Rock Choa Nim said, do you have any plan for summer vacation, and again, do you
summer
have any
vacation.
Specific place you plan for, and
maybe
international
not,
or like in Korea?
I would love to, well, both. I would love to go back to Canada, obviously, and see my family. That would be great. But it's hard when you're a singer in Korea and you constantly have to keep promoting. But maybe not. If not this summer, maybe next summer to go. I definitely want to go to Jeju-do one day, and or go to actually go visit Busan for a trip, not for like work. I want
to
go for a trip.
Rokjua said, if you want to go there. Who with? Your family members?
Family members or friends?
Or 보경 누나? Yes, they say so.
That'd be cool. Actually, I'd love to go with my family. I'd love to go with close friends like 보경 누나 or close friends from Witan too. Mm-hmm. That would be awesome to go visit parts of Korea that I haven't been to yet. Mm-hmm. That would be so awesome to go in the summer.
Wow. So. And Yo Shane asked you, when was it that you wrote your song for the first time? And
when
what
was
song
it?
Was it?
Oh my gosh, wow.
Don't remember.
Yeah, I remember. But honestly, I'm not one of these people that wrote a really young age. Mm-hmm. I started like last year of high school, honestly. Mm-hmm. I'd been uploading YouTube videos, and I got I did a lot of covers songs, and I saw a bunch of comments saying, you should write your own original songs. And I was like, that's not half bad. So I tried it. So the first original song I ever wrote, it's still on YouTube, actually. It's called It's called You're the One. And
You're the One.
You're the One.
You're the One.
You're the One. So that was the first one I wrote. It was like like literally 3 years ago.
Oh, really?
3 or 4 years ago. So mm-hmm. last year, that was in grade 12.
Okay. And Hukbaegi Mingyeong-nim said, how do you warm up your voice actually before you sing your song?
I guess normal ways, if I want to do an actual like warm up, then I find it's not good to really strain your voice too much at first. So, you know, regular ones. I was in a choir when I was really young, so I tend to do a lot of exercises.
Oh, yes, you know how to do it, actually.
You know, like...
Yes, yes, yes.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So, like, scales or arpeggios, I do a lot of those. And that's what I mainly do, try to get my voice warmed up.
And how's your Korean, I mean, learnings going?
It's coming along. It's, well, obviously... Like, I'm trying to improve every day. I try and study every single day and try and learn new words. And it's coming along. Although I'm not completely fluent, I feel like I'm really trying my best. And obviously, I'm going to keep on trying until I'm actually completely fluent. So.
Okay. And this is my favorite question. Siot Yung Nian-nim ask you, Shane... Can I ask Korean a little bit?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Shane이 너무 좋아요. 어떡해요? You know? She loves you. Okay, just marry him, man.
Okay.
Just marry him.
Oh
yeah,
my goodness.
I'll let you do. All right. So, last question. Which one should I... Okay.
The last question.
Okay, when you usually, how long do you go to bed, actually?
How long?
Like 7 hours, 8 hours?
Honestly, like some nights I'll get that much sleep, and other nights I'll go to bed like super late and I have to get up really early. Sometimes I have to go to school, like go to Korean class. So, yeah, it depends. Some nights I get like 8 hours sleep. Some nights I get like 4 hours of sleep.
Okay, this
which isn't
is
great.
Last question.
Oh, the actual one.
While when you play the songs while doing radio DJ, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So what do you do?
What do I do
while playing the song?
While playing the song, sometimes
actually I know it, right?
If it's a dance, if it's a dance song, sometimes I'll do a little dance.
Dance.
And if it's not, if it's like a ballad song, if it's like a really memorable singer that I know really well, I'll try and. I'll sometimes try and imitate them.
So it is, yes. We have like a lot of questions more, but you know, we don't have enough time
for it. We don't have enough time.
That's sad, kind of. Wow, what should I do?
Well, obviously, I hold like, sometimes I hold question times on my own Twitter. So if they still have questions, then I would definitely answer that on Twitter. But that was a lot of fun going over all those questions.
So anything like you want to talk about?
I just want to say that up until now, I just want to thank all my fans, obviously, since this is the last time. I just want to say thank you so much for staying with me now. Actually, just a couple days ago, it marked the one-year anniversary of my very first fan meeting.
Oh, yes.
After Bidi Antan Sang. So yes. I just want to say, it's been a little over a year since my very first fan meeting.
Also, radio show is 100.
Yeah, 100 days, so
right?
A lot of anniversaries. Wow. But up until now, I just want to thank my fans for staying with me up until everything, for standing by me through everything. And
wow.
Yeah. Really, really appreciate it, especially being a foreigner in Korea. So thank you so much.
Wow, and, I'm so happy because we can talk about you today.
We did!
So,
wow. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
So, but that pretty much...
We should, you know,
wrap it up.
Yes.
The thank you so much again for everything,
welcome,
you guys.
Shane.
The last song for our segment today is the new title song of my latest album called 707 with Kim Bok-young. It's by Bok-young and Shane. 내게 무슨 짓을 한 거야? But again, thank you so much for all your questions.
Welcome,
I had fun talking about myself. And
me too.
Yeah. I guess we'll see you next week, Song.
So much more about you.
Alright.
So, alright.
See you next week.
See you.
Bye.
Bye.
All the night. That's a ham hair. Sun so gachi nege tagawa. 사랑을 안기고 떠나가 오늘날 너의 기억에 잠을 설치면 내 추억 속에 네가 생각나 모두 부질없는 일인걸 이런 생각하다
머물렀다 깨할 건데 이미 주체 못할 일인걸. Oh, 사랑은 다시 돌아온다던 그 말. Oh, I don't believe 네 생각뿐이야. 내게 무슨 짓을 한 거야. Oh, 이런 생각하다
Han Goya. That was the latest from Bogyeong and Shane. Bogyeong and me, welcome back to Shane's Music Magic. We're just about ready to close off our part two on our Sunday show. And I just want to say thank you again for asking me so many interesting questions. But yeah, I really had fun a lot today on our K-pop tomorrow segment talking about me. And I hope you guys enjoyed the segment as well.